Okay, so we have subject pronouns, I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they. I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they. Now, after these subject pronouns, okay, subject pronouns, we use subject pronouns in place of nouns, en vez de nombres. Usamos pronombres. En vez de nombres. Okay? So, in place of I. In this case, I can't replace. In place of he. In place of he, I can use Carlos. Okay. Carlos. Carlos. In place of she, en vez de, okay? En vez de, in place of she, puedo utilizar Marianela. Okay, Marianela. In place of it, okay, it, en lugar de it, in place of it, I can use La Paz. Or the dog. The dog. Or the book. Okay, in place of he. It, sorry, it. In place of we, I can use in place of we. In place of we, I can say you and Carlos. No, no, no. We can say Carlos and I. Carlos and I. We. Hello?
Dicen, hay compañeros que quieren ingresar. Usted tiene que admitirles.
Ya están adentro. No tengo a nadie que solicita.
Han escrito al WhatsApp, dicen que no pueden entrar, pero bueno.
Están aquí 27 estudiantes, pero no. Hay que indicarles que están, por favor, me ayudan con eso. Que están con este link. Tal vez están intentando con el otro.
Ok.
Thank you. Okay. In place of Carlos, sorry, we, here we have we, Carlos and I, we. In place of you, okay, you, we can say you and Igor. You and Igor. They, Marianela, Igor, Marianela, Igor, and Carlos. Okay, so look at, in place of he, Carlos, she, Marianela, it, La Paz, the dog, the book. In place of we, Carlos and I, you, we can say, you and Igor. They, Marianela, Igor, and Carlos. What are we doing here? We are using subject. In this case, they are subject, proper nouns, nombres propios como sujeto, or subject pronouns, pronombre, objeto. I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they. So that means in place, en vez de. O utilizamos los pronombres o utilizamos los nombres en una oración? Any questions?
No questions.
No questions. Okay? So that's why, my friends, that's why we were using according to the subject, we need the verb be. According to the subject, we need the verb be. Okay? So in place we can say, estos dos pronombres no se pueden reemplazar, ¿ok? Tú es segunda persona, ¿ok? No se puede reemplazar, ¿ya? Por eso lo mantenemos ahí. No obstante, los otros sí se pueden reemplazar, ¿ok? So, I, su correspondiente verbo va a ser am, you are. Carlos is, Marianela is, the dog is, La Paz is, Carlos and I are, you and Igor are, Marianela, Igor and Carlos are. ¿Qué se llama ese grupo de palabras? Aquí solamente ya va a ser subject, ya no subject pronoun. En una oración afirmativa, y aquí está el verbo be. Verb be, como am, is o are. Posteriormente, ¿qué necesitamos? ¿Qué necesitamos?
Objetivo.
Object. 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 Okay, we need object. I am a teacher. Les dije, ¿no? De acuerdo al contexto vamos a entender esto. I am a teacher. I am una opción. Another option. I am at SETI. So you say this is cero estar. I am a teacher, soy profesora. I am at SETI, estoy en el SETI. You are a doctor. You are at SETI. Carlos is a dancer. Carlos is at SETI. Marianela is a what? What's your occupation, Marianela?
Auditor.
Accountant. Auditory accountant. accountant at SETI. La Paz is called, La Paz is a beautiful. Beautiful city. Carlos and I are teachers or students. Okay. Carlos and I are friends.
Partner.
Carlos and I are dentists. Igor and you are students. Marianela, Igor and Carlos are, sorry, it's not necessary here, because it's plural. Marianela, Igor and Carlos are students too. Or we can say good partners. Good partners. This is affirmative sentence, my friends. Okay? This is affirmative sentence. This is affirmative sentence. Affirmative sentence with verb be. What does verb mean? Ser or estar in Spanish. Questions? Thank you, Igor. Okay, my friends. Now it's missing negative sentence. Negative sentence. Look at it, says affirmative sentence, negative sentence. For negative sentence, also you need, what do you need? You need subject. You need subject. Plus the verb be. But this verb be must be with not. Okay? Verb be plus subject, verb be with not an object. An object and period. Don't forget. Subject, example, we can say Igor is not at the school. Igor is not at school. Igor is at university. Igor is not at school. Or you can say, I am, okay? So here we have the verb be. I am not at school. I am not a teacher. I am not a teacher. He is Igor, okay? She, Wendy, okay? Wendy is, now pay attention. We can use contraction, isn't. Contraction of is, not isn't. Wendy isn't a doctor. Wendy isn't a doctor. The dog isn't at park. It is the dog. Okay? We, We are not lawyers. We are not lawyers. They are Carlos and César. Carlos and César. Contraction also is possible, my friends. Carlos and César aren't teachers. This is the structure for negative sentence. Negative sentence with verb be. Subject, the verb be plus not plus object. I am, oops, here is missing. I am not a teacher. Okay, so it's possible to contract. Okay, it's possible to contract. The dog isn't at park. Isn't. Wendy isn't. He isn't. If you don't want to use Igor, you can use the pronoun he. He is not at the school. He isn't at the school. You can use subject pronoun or the proper noun, Wendy. Okay, so contraction isn't or is not. We are not, we aren't, Carlos and César aren't teachers, they aren't teachers. Okay, that is another way to use the structure for negative sentence. Any questions?
No question.
Thank you very much. Thank you. My friends, we can use contractions. Okay? We can use contractions. For example, I can contract am not a teacher. Look at am not a teacher. I'm not a teacher. You can use contraction his. He's not at school. He's not at school. Contraction. Okay. What are we contracting? We are contracting he and is. His. Or you can use contraction with the name Wendy's. Wendy's. Wendy's a doctor. Affirmative sentence. Negative sentence. Wendy's not a doctor. César's not a doctor. Carlos not a doctor. You can use the proper noun contraction with the verb be. Okay, you can contract here the verb be. Okay, what is contracted? Is. Wendy's. Okay, contraction. It's possible. In affirmative or negative, you can contract. The dogs, it's possible to contract. Apostrophe NS. The dogs isn't at park. The dogs not at park. That is the correct pronunciation. I am crazy, sorry. The dogs not at park. Or affirmative, the dogs at park. The dog is at park. The dogs at park. It's possible to contract. We're as well. It's possible. We're not lawyers. We're lawyers. Affirmative or negative, contraction. No cambia el significado. It's the same. We're not. Carlos and César, okay, Carlos and César, okay, here is not possible to contract with name. We need, what do you need? Pronoun. Pronoun is possible to contract. They, their, they are not teachers. Negative, affirmative, they are teachers. That is, my friends, when you use contraction, okay? Contraction. Contractions, subject, pronouns with the verb be. Okay, contractions, okay, contractions. Example, I am, you're, she's, we're, it's, contractions. Another contraction is the verb with negative, is, isn't, or aren't contractions. Of course, this is in mayúscula, capital letter. Okay, no problem. That is contractions. Any questions? Contractions. No questions. Excellent students. Thank you. There isn't contraction between the verb am with not. Never. The only possible is am, contraction am, not a teacher. But there isn't, am not. I am't a teacher. That's why it is wrong. And this is okay. Correct, incorrect. There isn't. It doesn't exist. No exist. It doesn't exist. The only option is he or she is. In this case, yes, it's possible. Contraction. Isn't. He isn't. She isn't. Or the other way, we, you, they, it's possible contract, the verb be are, and the negative, okay, aren't. It's possible to contract. We aren't, he isn't. But it's not possible, it is not possible contraction. I am not, amped. No. Okay? That's why, my friends.